Welcome to another video. Today we unbox the AMD Ryzen 7 3700X. This is the processor in the box. It comes with the cooling fan and it's a very nice box. The cooling fan has also RGB lights on. It's an 8-core 16-thread processor. AMD Ryzen 7 3700X. It's a pretty good one, a really good processor. And that's how you can see in the box the processor inside. Let's open it up with the sashimi knife. Well, that was a bit embarrassing. Let's move on.
Smell test. Smells pretty interesting.
They must be using glue with perfume on these processors. That's the model number of the fan, the Wraith Prism or something like that. And the processor sits nicely between two pieces of cardboard, so it can show in the box. It's a pretty small box for the. It's not very cheap processor, but okay. That's the box with the actual processor. This is the processor inside, and you even have a sticker if you want to put it somewhere. Try to be careful when you handle the processor that you don't bend any pins.
It's really heavy. Wow. Super heavy.
I don't think the weight is because of the silicone wafer, but most likely because of the cover that is meant for better cooling. In any way, it's a good processor. It feels really like it should be doing a lot of work. In the box you find some papers, but checking the pins to see if they're not bent already. Be careful when you open it, make sure you open it straight like this, not the other way around, and just grab it with the fingers. And yeah, so if you open it this way, it's a bit difficult to take it out. Really be careful, don't do that like that. So now what you should do before you install the processor, look at it from the side and just look at each row of pins and make sure they are straight, all of them. And do it from one side like this and then turn it around and do it from the other side. And this will tell you that all the pins are straight and it's ready to be installed. And this one is new, so it's all good. When you put it back, be careful not to put it somewhere in a place that you could bend the pins again. This is really easy to bend the pins on the AMD processors. And you find some paperwork inside. Yeah, the boring stuff as usual. But there is one paper here that you need to read. This one. There are some motherboards that need a BIOS update if you want to use these processors, the series 3000 series in them. The motherboard I have doesn't need a BIOS update, but you should check with your board manufacturer to get a BIOS update. That's one of the few pieces of paper that is actually useful in any computer part that I've seen, other than quick installation guide. Seems like this box works on the USB principle. You have to spin it 2 times before it goes in the right way. Let's have a look at the cooler. This is the interesting part. And it comes in a separate box. Wraith Prism, I think it's how you pronounce it. It's a pretty heavy one, not very light, so that's reassuring. Just checking it out and UE. This is the fan. The way this one lights up is it has a ring of color, and then the fan also lights up, and it's RGB, and it's controlled by the motherboard, so it's gonna be like a light show in the case. And for the RGB you have these cables. There is also the paste is pre-applied, and that's the connector to connect it to the motherboard. And the fan, it's pretty smooth. It's pretty interesting how they put the cables here. It's pretty nice, actually, just an easy way. So this is the RGB connection. You connect this to the Wraith Prism. The cooler has two ports, one with 3 pins, one with 4 pins. This one is with 4 pins, and the where the sign is the plus 12 volts sign. Even on the motherboard there is a square, there is something that shows that that's the first main pin. And this is a 3-pin connection on the Wraith Prism cooler going to a USB header for the motherboard. When you handle it, be careful not to touch the thermal paste. This is pre-applied, and it's important on these Ryzen processors to cover the whole area. Not like before where you put just a bit drop in the middle and it spreads a bit. If you replace this, make sure you cover the whole processor. So I'm going to try this pre-applied paste. I'm not gonna change it with something else, and I will see the temperatures, and then I will tell you later if it's you get anything more if you use a better paste, or this is good enough. The cooler looks pretty solid. There is a lot of heat spreading capability, a lot of heat pipes. It looks pretty good. Subscribe to find out more about the parts I got for this, and to see the build, because there will be a build video with all the parts together. Subscribe, like and share, and I will see you next time. Bye.